Welcome guys to the first online video session of module 2. So if you look at the V2 syllabus prescribed for this module 2 is of 8 hours, mainly containing two parts. First part deals with phase controlled converter. There we are going to learn about different controlling techniques, how to control the firing of your thyristors, that is a phase controlling techniques, and extension of that we are going to deal in detail about single phase half and full wave controlled rectifiers with both resistive and inductive loads, and finally conclude with studying the impact of having the freewheeling diode. Okay, this is the part one. The part two will just simply deal with some theoretical aspects like the basic operation and some step up or step down types of choppers, that one. Okay, so the test book already mentioned, like this one we have to follow here. So to initiate this one, so let us see what we exactly mean by this phase controlled converter. Okay, so what we mean by this phase controlled converter. Okay, so to initiate the today's discussion, so I want to go back to the basic study of rectifier, and we all know that what we mean by rectifier since from the first year as a part of basic electronics. We know that the rectifier is simply a switching circuit containing a single or more than one diode converting AC input to the pulsating DC, not pure DC, pulsating DC. That is what we mean by rectifier so far. Okay. So the problem here is that the problem with the rectifier, there also we came across if you use the single diode will be losing one peak, and if you use two diodes we are getting or recovering back the another peak also, we are getting two peaks for one complete cycle, no problem. But as you go adding the number of diodes, our efficiency of conversion from AC to DC is enhancing. Okay, that's what we all know basically about the rectifier. So depending on how much we are capable in converting AC to DC, okay, purely DC means it is straight line having zero frequency, okay, how much we are capable to reach that ideal stage, straight line, based on that we have got some different types of rectifiers here. So how well your output is controlled, we are able to control ನಮಗೆ ಯಾವ ಥರ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಬೇಕು, ಯಾವ ಥರ ಡಿ ಸಿ ಬೇಕು, ಪಲ್ಸೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಡಿ ಸಿ ಬೇಕು ಅಥವಾ ಪಲ್ಸೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಡಿ ಸಿ ವಿತ್ ಸಾರಿ ಮೋರ್ ರಿಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಲೆಸ್ ರಿಪಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಅನ್ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ಡ್ ರೆಕ್ಟಿಫೈರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಯೂಸಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಡಯೋಡ್ಸ್. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯರ್ ರೆಕ್ಟಿಫೈರ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಡಯೋಡ್ಸ್, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೋಟ್ಲಿ ಅನ್ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ಡ್. ಓಕೆ, the DC output voltage is fixed in amplitude by an input AC voltage. So what are the input amplitude is there, no? AC input amplitude, that is going to decide the fix up the amplitude of the output DC voltage, if at all if you are using the diodes or switching as a switching elements in the rectifier circuit. Okay, so thing is that this one is fixed here, that output amplitude what you are getting for the DC output voltage, no, the amplitude you are getting for DC output voltage, that is fixed, that is not under our control here. So that's why you can see, so neither our input or nor any means by any means we don't have any kind of a control over varying the three parameters of the output DC voltage what you are getting. We neither have the control over the amplitude. Suppose if I want this much of amplitude of DC output voltage, so so that I cannot get it because it is already decided by the amplitude of AC input. If I want this much of phase for DC output voltage, so this is what you can say. We neither have the control over the amplitude of DC output voltage nor the phase, desired phase for our output voltage what we want to get. Okay, that is uncontrolled rectifier. In this way we can see, you can see. Okay, if you use only diodes, this is how we will be having uncontrolled relationship between the input AC and output DC what you are getting. Okay, so next one, what we have, suppose if you include thyristors along with the diodes. Okay, for example, if you are using the full wave rectifier having a top one as a diode or bottom one as a thyristor, for example. Okay, in that case we'll be having a little bit around 50% of the control. There is a limited control over the DC output voltage will start getting. To some extent we can say we are able to have the control over the amplitude and phase of the output DC voltage as far as input AC is concerned. So we are able to establish certain kind of a relationship between the input AC and the output DC voltage. That is the thing. Okay, that is half a controlled rectifier, not fully. Okay, so next one, I hope you guess it correctly. That is a full controlled rectifier, only thyristors if you use. You can see here, slowly we started with the diodes, we got the things are uncontrolled. Okay, so the relationship between the output and input got uncontrolled. When you insert the 50% diodes and along with the thyristors, 50% we will be trying to have the control over the DC output voltage. When you purely depend on the thyristors, no any diodes here, no any silicon diodes, in that case the DC output voltage is fixed in amplitude by input AC with respect to firing angle. This is important here. Means, of course, in this case also the amplitude of the DC output voltage is fixed by the that of the AC, but is decided by the firing angle. Okay, at what angle your thyristor got triggered. Okay, you will be knowing, no, for one cycle it will be having 0 to 360 degree variation of the firing angle. So at what angle you are going to trigger your thyristor, at zero angle you are going to trigger your thyristor, or 30 degree you want to trigger your thyristor, or 90 degree, or else any other degree varying from 0 to 360 is going to decide the output DC voltage amplitude as far as the AC input is concerned. So that relation is now controlled, fully controlled by this triggering of firing angle. Okay, at what angle you are going to trigger your thyristors. So in this way guys, we got totally three main categories here for your rectifier: uncontrolled, half controlled, both are mixed here, and full controlled, only depending on the thyristors. So like this, suppose we can group the first two types as unidirectional here. What we are going to do here, we are grouping the first two, the uncontrolled and half controlled, okay, which are not fully controlled, the first two categories. Okay, are categorized or grouped into unidirectional rectifiers. Okay, so let us see how. Okay, in case of uncontrolled rectifier, if you are using only diodes, maybe half or full, means depending on single or two diodes if you are using. There we have seen that the current direction is going only from source, that is AC, where you are applying the input, that is AC signal, that is from source to the load, means where you are getting the DC output. Okay, means the direction of the current is going only from source to the load, not coming back to the source. That's what is unidirectional. Similarly, in case of half controlled rectifier, if you are using one diode and one thyristor, in that case also one or the other peak will get the direction of the current flowing in only one direction, that too from source to load only, not in a vice versa back, adverse direction. Okay, so that's why these two are grouped under unidirectional rectifiers. So another one, hope you guess it correctly, it is a bidirectional full control rectifier. So here we can make the current to flow in both the directions, from source to load, that is AC to DC, or from load to source, that is DC to AC. Both the types of conversions is possible. So that's why you can see in your home or domestic purpose, what you're using is inverter mode, which is capable to do the conversions in the both way, okay, AC to DC or DC to AC. But here it is a unidirectional, it is not called as inverter, but it is called a converter mode, where you are just simply converting from AC to DC. It is just a conversion, okay, that's what is known as a converter mode. But here you are converting from AC to DC plus DC to AC also, you are able to do it, that is inversion of that. So that's what is known as a inverter mode, means you are able to convert also from DC to AC, AC to DC, and also you are able to convert its exact replica of that, that is DC to AC, you are able to do it. That's what is known as a inverter mode. Okay, remember these guys, these are very important basic things we are learning here. The first two types are coming under unidirectional, and the later one is coming under bidirectional. And based on how they are going to operate, or how the current flow is there from source to load, or vice versa, they are classified as converter or inverter mode, like that. So based on such kind of things, we have got such kind of basic types of rectifiers. Now coming back to what we mean by the phase controlled converter, that what our basic issue. Okay, so what we exactly mean by the phase controlled converter, one thing you remember guys, phase controlled converter, as far as I mean at this stage, is it is simply a rectifier, okay, consisting of thyristors, or maybe the hybrid one along with the diodes, okay, and doing both the things, maybe unidirectional or bidirectional, by what you can say, you are going to control over the amplitude of the output by varying the phase angle of your firing or triggering of your thyristors. Okay, means you are going to have the control over the output by the triggering angle of the gate pulse. Okay, so based on how the phase is controlled, will be having different types of such kind of things are known as such kind of rectifiers, which are providing us some means of control over the output as far as the input is concerned, with the help of the phase controlling. Okay, so because when you trigger the input at a particular firing angle, the phase relation between the input and output is not going to be same, it is going to be different. So this different in phase is now going to have certain kind of a control over our output. Okay, so such kind of controlling over the output of rectifier with the help of the phase relationship between the input and output is known as a phase controlled converter. Okay, so take so some different controlling techniques are there. Before we'll go in deep about the phase controlled converters, so different types of phase controlled converters are there. Okay, so this one is known as a one quadrant phase controlled converter. So this one is known as one quadrant, because first quadrant you can see, so we all know the basic graph. So it is a x-axis and this one is a y-axis. If you draw like that, you will be getting four quadrants here. This one is both x and y coordinates are positive here. That is the first quadrant. Second quadrant will get x negative and y positive. And similarly, at the bottom here, you will get the third quadrant. There will get both x and y negative. And the fourth quadrant finally will be getting the y negative and x positive, like that. So based on in the similar fashion, we'll be having a simple or basic types of study of phase controlled converters here. So here you can see, so it is known as a one quadrant, means a first quadrant phase controlled converter, means rectifier which is going to show its performance characteristics in the first quadrant like this. Here you will be getting its performance curves. Okay, so the circuit is simply is of controlled rectifiers or uncontrolled rectifiers in different circuit positions. You can see here it may be having it is hybrid type, or maybe purely it may contain diodes, or purely it may contain thyristors like that. Okay, AC input and DC output here you are getting. Okay, so only one polarity of the current or voltage is possible at DC terminals. Okay, so unidirectional, it may be uncontrolled or controlled, you can say half controlled, which are coming under unidirectional. So one polarity of voltage means both are positive. That is only one type of polarity we are getting with this type of phase controlled converter. That's what is known as a first quadrant or one quadrant phase controlled converter. Next, hope you are correct, your guessing is correct. That is a two quadrant we are getting. Okay, so two quadrant controlled converter. So the controlled rectifiers are in all circuits. Okay, these are going to be part of circuit in all positions. So only thyristors you are using, no any diodes are allowed here. And you can see its performance characteristics can be shown by the first and fourth quadrant. So that's why you can see it is known as a two quadrant phase controlled converter. And power can be made to flow either from AC to DC or from DC to AC, both types of conversions. Okay, bidirectional conversions is possible. So that's why in the fourth quadrant you can see it is written as an inverter, means in this quadrant whatever the performance curves you are getting, which are indicating the operation of this two quadrant phase controlled converter, is giving you the glimpse that this kind of circuit is acting like an inverter. But here it will give the glimpse, the performance curves will give you an idea that this circuit is acting like a simply a rectifier. It is unidirectional, here it is behaving, and here it is behaving like a bidirectional device. Okay, so this how guys you need to explain in your own words, whatever with your own basic knowledge what you learned so far. So this is the second type of phase controlled converter, that is a two quadrant phase controlled converter. Next one is you are correct, that is a four quadrant phase controlled converter. So here you can see the thyristors. So remember one thing, diodes are allowed only in the first type, okay, one quadrant, where it is acting like a rectifier simply, except the quadrant one. In remaining all quadrants, okay, except the diagonal one, in remaining all quadrants will be getting either converter or inverter mode of operation. And here you can see the four quadrant phase controlled converter, your thyristors are connected in a back-to-back fashion. Okay, so remember one thing, here we are not going in deep about the circuit, just you need to practice these block diagrams and simple graphs and try to put your basic knowledge, whatever you have about the basic of these circuits, in your enhancing of your explanation. So it contains two quadrant converters connected back to back. So converter one, here it is acting like a rectifier, here is also converter two acting like inverter. Okay, first two quadrants are devoted to the converters, means where the current direction is flowing in only one way. Okay, so here also the current direction is only one way, but only in this quadrant will be getting bidirectional current flow. Okay, in both these things, inverter quadrants, the second and fourth quadrant where we are getting inverter operation behavior of this four quadrant phase controlled converter. Okay, so this how guys we need to explain about the basic types of phase controlled conversion. Then quickly we'll just start we'll go with one basic circuit, so which are coming under different control techniques. The first part today what we covered is what you mean by phase controlled converter, from the basic concept of the rectifiers, how we classified it, and different types we have seen so far in terms of the phase controlled converter. Okay, one thing what we have learned so far here is how your rectifier itself is modified, how its operation itself is got manipulated or modified into so that we can to be in a situation to call it as a controlled converter, phase controlled converter. Okay, so now to have this phase controlled converter, we'll be having different control techniques, no? Okay, like that it may be a phase angle control or firing angle control, both are same. That is the first type. So here you can see there is simple circuit is there for you to understand. So simple AC supply we are giving, because it is a rectifier or a converter we are dealing with. Okay, so AC supply is there, having its own inductance. Either it may be external if you want, you can think, or it may be internal, because any power supply having its own internal inductance. Okay, now in series with this we'll be having a switch. Okay, so that is going to provide you the control voltage. Here you can see we'll be getting the control voltage. Supply voltage is this one. Okay, AC sin or cos, sorry, this one is AC sin omega t. Okay, because sin will be 0 at 0, not cos. Cos is going to be maximum at 0, then it should be AC sin omega t. Okay, so that is supply voltage, and AC is the control voltage is given by this, where you are going to, when you put this on, then you will be giving the firing angle, and your thyristor will be turned on like that. Okay, and this one is a control voltage, and two types of control voltages are there. That we can see when going to in operation explanation. Okay, now you can see here we have only one switch, that is a thyristor. Only one thyristor is there, so that's why we'll be having we'll be calling it as a half wave controlled converter using unidirectional switch. Okay, the supply voltage is here. Okay, so when the switch is closed or on, okay, means when you trigger control voltage, means when you gate voltage, you can think for your convenience to understand. So initially you are not applying any gate voltage or control voltage, okay, in order to trigger your ACR, unless and until you apply that gate pulse or control voltage here. Okay, your thyristor is not in the conduction mode, it is in the blocking mode. So from 0 to you can see, think of this one as alpha duration, 0 to alpha, you are not applying any gate signal. Means your thyristor is in the off state, blocking state. Means this one is open circuited, and whatever the input is there, that is happening across this only. Happening across this only, not across the load. Okay, so load voltage here you can see, that's why it is 0 here. Means where it has gone, it is appearing across this. Okay, so once you at a time omega t equal to alpha, if you apply the gate pulse, then suddenly your thyristor will be turned on at this instant. Okay, this will switch S will be closed, and the current will start flowing through the load, and you can see whatever the input was there across the switching element, that is thyristor, now it will be shifted to the load from alpha to pi. Okay, for the duration of alpha to pi. Okay, so for this much of duration, because your thyristor will be on, so that's why all the input is coming across the load. That's why the load is getting same as that of the input. Again, the amplitude of this one is decided by the value of R here. That's what is known as a R controlled converter. If the value of R is more, amplitude may be more, amplitude is going to vary. The value of R is less, amplitude is going to vary once again, maybe increasing or decreasing, it is going to change. Means here R is going to have the control over the what load voltage you are going to get. Okay, and one another thing, when your thyristor is on and off, that one. Okay, this one is the control voltage that will be given only once through the gate to the SCR, then it will be removed after a time gap of low, very small time gap of low. Okay, then automatically here you can see when your input will reach zero, automatically the thyristor will be turned off, means it is a natural commutation is happening here throughout the negative peak from pi to 2 pi. Again here the one cycle will complete, guys, from 0 to 2 pi. Our explanation is over. Again the things are going to repeat. Again when you are going to apply the gate pulse in the next consecutive or successive positive peak, till that your SCR is in the off state only, means your no SCR output, load voltage. Okay, your load voltage is getting only when this will be on. This will be on only when you will get apply the gate pulse or triggering pulse in the next, that is at a DO value in the next positive peak. Okay, so these are the so this is the technique where you are going to trigger your thyristor as a part of the phase as a part of the half way controlled converter. You are going to use what? You are going to have the control over the rectifier operation of this one half way controlled converter by just by applying the gate pulses. That's why it is also known as a pulse triggered technique. This one is also known as a pulse triggered technique because we are using pulses, gate pulses here, to turn on the thyristors subsequently or successively in each of the successive cycles. Okay, and again by varying this alpha, the phase angle will be having its impact on the what output voltage will be getting. Suppose if this one will vary now, then this width will also vary, and again the amount of what output you are now getting is going to be reduced compared to the previous one. At this angle of alpha, your output is this much, area under curve is this much, it is large. But when you further increase, if you delay in applying the gate pulse, means alpha got increased, then whatever the curve you are getting, area under curve is going to be reduced compared to this one now. Means the output, the magnitude of the load voltage, it is heavily depending on the firing angle or phase angle. Okay. So another kind of control what we'll be having, which is normally used in the MOSFETs or insulated gate bipolar transistor or bipolar junction transistor, is we are not applying any gate pulse here, but here we are applying one square level kind of thing. Okay, so one square pulse is applied for the entire duration of a thyristor which was on. Okay, so as long as this control voltage is on, your thyristor is on. Okay, means this is known as a level triggered. Level triggered means as far as you are going to maintain this one level, so this magnitude may be plus 1, plus 2 or plus 5 volt or whatever. Okay, as long as you are going to maintain this level, okay, your thyristor is on, otherwise it will be off. Okay, so this is coming known as a level triggered technique. Okay, so two techniques we learned here, guys, with respect to the circuit and a waveform here. One is a phase angle or firing angle control, how it is going to have an impact on the amplitude. Amplitude got reduced if you go on increasing the firing angle, that I explained. Just to listen it again and write down. Another one is a level triggered control. Okay, this also will be having impact on the what amount of output voltage you will be getting. Okay. So here you can see it has been shown pulse triggered and level triggered. Just now I have discussed pulse triggered is mostly used in the SCRs and GTOs. Level triggered mainly used in the MOSFETs or insulated gate bipolar transistors. So this phase angle control is a means of controlling the average power to the load. Just now I explained, mainly used in the lamps, heaters, motors, DC suppliers, etc. Okay. This already I explained as a part of operation in the last but one slide. Okay, so as you can see, these are also known as a line commutated converters, because turning on and off of the thyristor is automatically, it is happening whenever the input will cross the zero, automatically your SCR will be turned off. Okay, it is not we don't need another triggering pulse here, gate pulse. We don't need another level pulse here to turn off, as we would be requiring to turn on the thyristor. So that's why these are known as a line commutated converters, because line it is a line signal, supply voltage is a line signal. Automatically, when line voltage naturally it will cross the zero, your thyristor will be naturally turned off. That's what is also known as a line commutated. Commutated means turning off converters, means your rectifiers. Okay, so these are the two techniques we learned so far. One is a pulse trigger technique, another one is a level trigger technique. So another one, what you are getting is extension angle control technique. So in this case, you can see here, load voltage means you are getting here, means during this instance from 0 to beta, your what you can say, whatever the input you are getting, it is appearing across the load, means your thyristor is on for this duration. Okay, but you are applying one triggering pulse here to turn it off, because you can see at this instant of omega t equal to beta, your load output voltage suddenly got reduced to zero. No output means your thyristor got switched into the blocking state. No more current. It is now opened. Open means no current flowing in the circuit. It is open circuited, hence no load voltage. Means we are using another gate pulse here to turn off your ACR. We are not using natural. We are using some force technique here, guys. That is a pulse trigger technique to turn off your ACR. Similarly, you can see the next subsequent successive peak also, we are using another pulse here to turn off. So this technique where we are going to use the pulses to turn off your commutation operation, okay, is known as extension angle control. Okay, or else you can see, if you want, you can turn on the SCR for the prescribed period of duration. So of the this level control, that is as long as this square or rectangular pulse is there with this level, we are able to keep your SCR turn on. Otherwise it will be turned off like this. This one is a level trigger switching. Again, in extension angle control, this is how we are able to apply the things to turn off the ACR forcibly, not naturally. Here forced commutation is happening, that is, you remember, guys. These are all the things you need to use in your explanation. So last one, what you are getting is a pulse width modulation technique here. Okay, so here the output will also be decided by depending on this dough. Okay, depending on this row here. So here we are using turn on pulses, okay, and turn off pulses, means pulse triggered things we are using. Two pulses we are using to turn on and turn off. Okay, and level trigger is very simple. You simply use one level triggered pulse if you want to keep it on, otherwise it will be turned off like this. This one is a level triggered, and this is how pulse trigger. Here you are using two pulses. Sorry, not in the previous cases where we are using the gate pulses either to turn on or to turn off. Okay, so in this case we used the gate pulse to turn on, and in this case we used the gate pulse to turn off. Sorry about that one. Okay, we are not using two gate pulses to turn on and off. That is coming here now in case of pulse width modulation. Okay, so this is how, guys, you again now try to explain here during this the first gate pulse. Okay, when you're going to explain how the pulse triggering is used to turn on and off, and for the rectifier operation of this phase control rectifier, that circuit you can use. This first gate pulse is used to turn on your SCR. Okay, then load voltage that has not been shown here, you can draw it here. Will be getting here because the thyristor will be short circuited or on. Okay, at this instant, till that there is no load output voltage. Illi indirutana load output voltage irutate, but when you apply the turn on pulse, your thyristor will be on and will start getting zero output. Sorry, now output will be shifted from across the SCR to the load like this. Okay, so like that, how we have explained the two or three may previous circuits operation, in the similar fashion you try to explain this technique that is known as a pulse width modulation control. So far, guys, we have covered two important things here. The one what we basically mean by rectifier operation in the context of phase control rectifier and its different types. Second one, we also discussed different types of control techniques. Okay, I will stop here.